One of the biggest debated space topics in the world history is the moon landing, and it's no surprise that it's still being debated today, since the last mission we were there was Apollo 17 in the 70s. That's more than 50 years ago. Did NASA and the US really land on the moon, or was it a piece of propaganda to win the space race with the Soviet Union? Now let's unravel this mystery. The year was 1969, and the United States was in a heated space race with the Soviet Union. NASA had been working hard towards the goal of landing a man on the moon since the late 1950s, and in 1961, President John F. Kennedy boldly promised to achieve the goal of landing a man on the moon within the next decade. The Apollo program was a series of missions that aimed to land humans on the moon and return them safely to Earth, starting from 1961 upwards to a decade. But as the deadline approached, it became clear that the project was far from complete. Then on July 20th, 1969, Apollo 11 made history when Neil Armstrong became the first person to step onto the moon, followed by Buzz Aldrin. The last mission was Apollo 17, which departed from the moon on December 14, 1972, marking the end of the Mandalorian exploration. The moon landings were widely celebrated as a triumph of science, technology, and human spirit. They were also seen as a decisive victory for the US in the Cold War space race with the Soviet Union, which had launched the first artificial satellite, Sputnik, in 1957, and the first human in space, Yuri Gagarin, in 1961. The moon landings inspired generations of people around the world to pursue careers in science and engineering, and to explore the mysteries of the universe. But soon after the moon landing, many conspiracy theorists started to raise questions.
Not one astronaut has been on the moon.
Well, I'm afraid not.
No Apollo ever landed on the moon. It's all a lie.
I'm afraid so.
They claimed that the footage of the moon landing was a fake, and that the government had staged the whole thing in a Hollywood studio, and it was directed by none other than Stanley Kubrick. There were a lot of questions about the moon landing footage that has started to pile up. Why were there no stars visible in the background? Why were the shadows not parallel? Why were the American flags waving in the wind when there was no wind on the moon? Many questions were raised, and there were no sufficient answers. So many conspiracy theorists start to speculate. One of their speculation was that Stanley Kubrick, a filmmaker at the time, was the director of the moon landing hoax. Kubrick, who is considered one of the greatest filmmakers of all time, the director of 2001 A Space Odyssey, a movie released in 1968 and widely regarded as one of the best science fiction films of all time and probably the most influential. The movie features groundbreaking special effects, which still hold up today. This collaboration with science fiction author Arthur C. Clarke tells the story of an alien intelligence that visited Earth in the distant past and left behind artifacts in the solar system. In fact, the effects look so good, almost too real. Only some of Stanley diehard fans started to notice the similarities in the camera angles in both the Space Odyssey and the moon landing footage were too much to ignore. Some fans believe that since the US government went multiple billions of dollars deep in the Apollo program with no apparent progress, they needed an urgent achievement to beat the Soviets, who were still years ahead of the United States. NASA deliberately needed to get to the moon before Russia, but they knew it was impossible, so they hired Stanley Kubrick to film a fake moon landing footage for the television and to convince the taxpayers and the government officials that those billions spent were not for nothing. There were many books about the moon landing, but the first book to popularize the moon landing hoax theory was We Never Went to the Moon, America's $30 billion swindle, published in 1974 by Bill Kaysing, a former employee of Rocketdyne, a company that helped design the Saturn V rocket engines. Kaysing claimed that he had inside information that revealed that the moon landings were impossible to achieve with the technology available at the time, and that NASA had staged them using special effects and actors. He also alleged that some people who knew too much about the hoax were either threatened by NASA and the CIA or outright disappeared into thin air. As the question started to pile up, conspiracy theorists became more and more vocal about their beliefs. They pointed to a lot of evidence to support their claims. One piece of evidence was the fact that there was no crater underneath the lunar module. According to them, this would have been impossible if the spacecraft had landed on the moon. Another piece of evidence presented was the lack of any stars in the background of the footage. Experts argued that the astronauts were on the bright side of the moon, where the sun was shining, and the brightness of the sun made the stars invisible. The most compelling pieces of evidence are the destroyed technologies of the moon landing and the argument surrounding the Van Allen radiation belt.
Go to the moon in a nanosecond. The problem is we don't have the technology to do that anymore. We used to, but we destroyed that technology, and it's a painful process to build it back again. But going to Mars should be one of the next series of steps that humans do. The first step should be going back to the moon for a number of technical reasons and exploration reasons, and then after that, Mars, maybe a high orbit in Venus atmosphere, maybe going to Europa. There's all kinds of targets to go to, places of interest in our solar system. The only limit to human future is in our own imaginations.
According to this, we can go to Mars and Jupiter or Saturn moons using different technologies than the technologies used to go to the moon. This statement, whether a slip of the tongue or not, fuels the theory of NASA faking the moon landing. On the other hand, the Van Allen radiation argument debunks the possibility of human space travel, simply because the belt is a zone of energetic charged particles, mostly protons and electrons, that are trapped by Earth's magnetic field. These particles come from the solar wind, which is a stream of plasma that flows from the sun. Earth has two main belts, the inner belt, which extends from about 640 to 13,000 miles above the surface, and the outer belt, which stretches from 13,000 to 58,000 miles above the surface. Sometimes there may be a third belt or a slot region between the belts, depending on the solar activity, so any electronics or humans to pass that belt will be fried beyond recognition. While the conspiracy theories presented some compelling pieces of evidence, many experts and scientists argue against the idea that the moon landing was fake. For starters, the United States government would have needed a conspiracy of enormous proportions to fake the moon landing. NASA had over 400,000 employees working on the space programs at the time, and it's hard to believe that all of them would have kept quiet about the alleged hoax. Additionally, if the moon landing was a fake, the Soviet Union would have almost certainly pointed this out, which they never did. While the controversy surrounding the moon landing continues to generate a lot of heat, it is unlikely that it was a hoax. It is true that there are some inconsistencies in the footage, but the technical limitations of the era and the conditions of the missions can account for those inconsistencies. The moon landing remains one of the greatest achievements of human history, one that opened new frontiers and came to stand as inspiration to many. It was a feat that took years of research, experimentations, and hard work to accomplish. While the truth may never be uncovered, one thing is for certain. The journey to the moon and the mission that took place was, without a doubt, an incredible achievement. Now that we have come to the end of this video, please let me know in the comments about what you think of this mystery. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so. And while you're at it, please leave a thumbs up. My name is Jeff, and this has been another episode of Mysteries Unraveled. See you in the next one.